Here we have a problem where we need to solve the dot product between two three-dimensional vectors that have a variable x inside of them. So we want the dot product of vector A dot vector B. And we're just going to start writing those vectors out, A dot B, with their different dimensions. And then when we're doing this, remember, dot product is multiplication. So we need to multiply these things. And it's just like before, we need to distribute. So we take the 3xi times 4xi. And that gives me 12x squared I dot I. And then we take the 3xi times the second term. And then that gives me minus 15x I dot j. And then we take the 3xi times the third term. And we get 21x squared I dot k. Then we have to distribute the second term inside of vector A. So we do 2x squared j times the 4xi. And that gives me 8x cubed j dot I. Then we take that times the next term, and we get minus 10x squared j dot j. And then we take the middle term times the last term, and we get 14x cubed j dot k. Then we go ahead with the last term of A, and we distribute that across, and we get minus 4x k dot I plus 5 k dot j. And then we take the last terms, and that gives us minus 7x k dot k. Now remember, the dot product talks about how much of those two vectors are in the same direction. So really, I dot I are in the same direction. So that's just going to give us 1. So I dot I is 1. I dot j, well, I and j are perpendicular to each other, so I dot j is 0. I dot k is also perpendicular, so that gives us 0. J dot I, again, perpendicular, gives us 0. J dot j, same direction, gives us 1. J dot k, perpendicular, gives us 0. K dot I, perpendicular, gives us 0. K dot j is also perpendicular, so that gives us 0. And then lastly, k dot k, same direction, so that gives us 1. So what we have left is we have the 12x squared, we have minus 10x squared, and we have minus 7x. So we combine that all together, and that gives us 2x squared plus 7x.